Here in I button and description box below, you will get complete playlist of Laplace transform. And here we are going to solve a problem which is from the topic inverse Laplace transform. Basically, I would like to show you something that is from video number 19. Okay, from video number 19 to video number, yes, that is 30. We are solving various problems on the topic inverse Laplace transform. All these questions are very, very, very important. I would suggest you, I would request you to solve each and every problem, okay, and that too in this sequence only, in this sequence only, so that you will get very good command over this topic, okay, and over this, all these questions, out of all these questions, this question number 27 is most important problem, okay. Other questions are also very important, but this is the most important problem, okay. So let us start with the problem. Welcome to video number 30, and in this video we are going to solve a very beautiful question, that is question number 12. And the question is, find the inverse Laplace transform of cot inverse of s upon 2. Okay, cot inverse of s upon 2. This is one of the good questions, I should say. Let us start this solving this problem. Let f bar of s equals to cot inverse of s upon 2. Let's suppose this is what? This is my f bar of s. Okay, yes. You must know one formula, okay, that is cot inverse of x equals to tan inverse of 1 upon x. Okay, I am repeating this formula once again, that is cot inverse of x, that is equals to tan inverse of 1 upon x. Applying this formula here, that is cot inverse of s upon 2 can be written as tan inverse of 1 upon s upon 2. And we can write, that is 1 upon s upon 2, that is 2 upon s. So tan inverse of 1 upon s upon 2 can be written as tan inverse of 2 upon s. Now we are going to differentiate. Okay, now we have to differentiate both sides with respect to s. Okay, so f bar of s will become d upon ds of f bar of s. Okay, and this part, that is tan inverse of 2 upon s, is going to be d upon ds of, okay, that is differentiation of tan inverse of 2 upon s with respect to s. Okay, yes, and we know that differentiation of tan inverse of x is what? 1 upon 1 plus x square. Okay, and the value of x is how much? 2 upon s. So this is going to be 1 upon 1 plus 2 upon s whole square. Now again differentiating this with respect to s, so 2 being constant will be, okay, as it is, and 1 upon s, differentiation of 1 upon s is going to be minus 1 upon s square. Okay, yes. Differentiation of 1 upon s is going to be minus 1 upon s square. So we can write d upon ds of tan inverse of 2 upon s, that is equals to 1 upon 1 plus 2 upon s whole square into 2 into minus of 1 upon s square. Now you can see minus 2. Okay, we have written here minus 2. Okay, and in the denominator part, we have 1 plus 2 upon s whole square. Okay, 2 upon s square. So we are taking s square. Yes, common, that is LCM. Okay, so we have, okay, let me wrap this first. Okay, so if you take s square common, so this is going to be s square, and this is as it is, that is 2 square, and this is s square. Okay, so we have minus 2 upon s square here, and this is going to be s square plus 2 square upon s square. Okay, yes, so here we can cancel out this s square. Okay, now we are left with what? Minus 2 upon s square plus 2 square. Okay, now we are going to, yes, now taking inverse Laplace transform on both the sides. So we are left with, yes, we are taking inverse Laplace transform on both the sides, that is inverse Laplace transform of d upon ds of f bar of s. Okay, and from this side we have taken this minus 2 being constant. Okay, that is minus 2 into inverse Laplace transform of 1 upon s square plus 2 square. Okay, now we are going to see what is the derivative property in the case of inverse Laplace transform. Okay, so here we are seeing the properties of inverse Laplace transform, and look at this fourth property, that is derivative property. And according to this, inverse Laplace transform of d upon ds of f bar of s equals to minus t into f of t. Okay, so we are applying this formula, that is inverse Laplace transform of d upon ds of f bar of s can be written as what? Minus t into f of t. Minus t into f of t. Okay. Now, minus 2 is as it is. Inverse Laplace transform of 1 upon s square plus a square. Okay. The formula we have, 1 upon a into sine a t. And the value of a is how much? 2. Okay, so the formula will be 1 upon 2 into sine 2t, and we can see 2 will get cancelled, this negative negative will get cancelled. So finally we are left with what? Sine 2t. Okay, and here we have t into f of t. So if you want to find the value of f of t, then it is sine 2t upon t, and this is my final answer. Okay, thank you so much.